Welcome to VGuy TV. In this video, I'll explain electricity part 2. I'm going to discuss questions based on power now. Power. See the question. Incandescent bulbs are designed by keeping in mind that resistance of their filament increases with increase in temperature. So what is the meaning? We use bulb. So we have an idea that the resistance of the filament will increase with the temperature. At room temperature, 10 watt, 16 watt and 40 watt bulb filament resistance are R100, R60 and R40 respectively. Write the relation of the resistance. Write the relation of the resistance. I need to tell you about Joule's law. We all know that Joule's law is nothing but I square RT, V square by R into T, and another equation is VIT. If you look at the second equation, this is the equation connecting voltage, resistance and time. Right? Voltage, resistance and time. If you need power, power is nothing but rate of heat. That means heat divided by time is the power. So all the three equations, if T is not there, that is I square R, V square by R, VI, that are the equation for power. Okay? So in that form, I have written here the power equation as V square by R. I am connecting three bulbs here, 100 watt, 60 watt and 40 watt. So for all the bulb, my supply voltage is same. So I can write the very important case that the power is inversely proportional to resistance for constant voltage. Power is inversely proportional to resistance for constant voltage. So from this value, I understood that power of 100 watt bulb is greater than power of 60 watt bulb is greater than power of 40 watt bulb. So we can write here, 1 by R100 is greater than 1 by R60 is greater than 1 by R40. So that option they gave it in the question. That's all. So the thing is, you should get an idea that how the power and resistance are related. Power and resistance are inversely proportional. It means as resistance increases, power decreases. But here in the option they gave about 1 by R. So that's what we got it in the same order. P100 greater than P60 greater than P40. Therefore 1 by R100 greater than 1 by R60 greater than 1 by R40. Okay. Same thing. If there is no 1 by me, how it will come? R40 is greater. R40 is greater. I am writing that also. R40 is greater than R60 is greater than R100. So what is the meaning? 1 by R100 is greater means what about R100? R100 is less. R100 is less. So it means that for a 100 watt bulb, resistance is less. For a 40 watt bulb, resistance is more. Power and resistance are inversely proportional. Clear? It's a very, very important question. Three resistances of equal resistance are connected as shown in the figure. So see, there are three resistances. They marked it like this. Okay. R, R, R. Find equivalent resistance. Looking like a series connection, but it's not a series connection. It is a parallel combination. What is called parallel combination? So I always tell a shortcut. Parallel means N points should be same. N points are same. Parallel means what should be same? N points should be same. So here they gave the resistance here A. The point here as A. This point as B. It means for all the three resistors, one end point at A, other end point at B means we can call it as a parallel connection. So I am taking one resistance. Take the first resistance 1. One endpoint is A, no problem. One endpoint is directly connected to A. Another endpoint is connected to C, but the C is connected to which point? B. So I can write for first resistance, one endpoint is A, another endpoint is C, C is connected to B. See the second resistance. One endpoint is C, C is nothing but connected to B, C is connected to B. Another endpoint is connected to D for the second resistance, but the D has a connection with our A. So D and A are connected for the second resistance. If you check for the third resistance, it is connected to D. D and A are connected. D and A are connected. And the another endpoint is directly connected to B. It means that all the three resistance, one endpoint is A, another endpoint is B. It means that their endpoints are same. So they are which connection? Parallel. If it is parallel connection, we can write 1 by RP is 1 by R plus 1 by R plus 1 by R. That is 3 by R. If you want RP, it is R by 3. So my answer is R by 3. All three resistors are in parallel because their endpoints are same. Now I can tell another shortcut equation. If n equal resistances are in parallel, there is a shortcut equation, RP equals R by N. Here how many resistors? 3. So answer is R by 3. If 5 we are connecting, R by 5. So that is a shortcut equation for solving quickly the answers. Clear? So RP is equal to R by N. Clear the question? So parallel means N points should be same. See my next question. An electric bulb is rated for 500 watt at 100 volt is used in a circuit having 200 volt supply. This case, I'm using a bulb of 500 watt and 100 volt and it is connected to 200 volt. The resistance R that must be connected in series with the bulb so that bulb draws 500 watt is. So what they told, we are connecting another resistance in series with this bulb. But we need to draw the power of 500 watt. Okay. So what I am doing is, first I am going to calculate what is the current going through this bulb. Okay. So current is, the first question I discussed you, power we can write equation I square R, VI and another one is V square by R. So from that, the second equation, I can write I equals P by V. P is 500 and V is 100. 500, 100. So 500 by 100 is 5 ampere. Clear? So what is the current going? 5 ampere. Now, what we are doing, we know that across the bulb, we need a voltage of 100 voltage. So I am giving here 200 voltage. Out of this 200, 100 voltage is going for the bulb. So what is the remaining voltage for the resistance? This remaining voltage across the resistance is 200 minus 100, that is 100 volt. Then I used my Ohm's law. These two are connected in series. You know, for series connection, what should be same? Current remains same. So what is the current through this bulb? That will be the same current if you go like this also. So I can find the resistance by using simple Ohm's law. R equals V dash by I. V dash is 100. I is 5. So 100 by 5. What is 100 by 5? 20 ohm. We'll go for the next question. The length of the conducting wire is increased by 100%. The change in resistance of the wire is very important question. The length of the conducting wire is increased by 100%. What is the meaning of length increase by 100%? I'm using a resistance equation. R is equal to rho L by A. Okay. You can just multiply both numerator and denominator with an L. That is rho L square by AL. A into L is nothing but volume. So you remember, if you increase the length by 100%, it means we may be stretching the wire. In that way, we are increasing the length. So, in those type of questions, you remember the shortcut formula, resistance is proportional to L square. Okay. So, you see, it's little contradictory. Here, the question they are given, the length of the conducting wire is increased by 100%. It means we are stretching the wire and we are extending to 100%. So, in those cases, so for those stretching cases, I can write length is proportional to L square. Then, what is the meaning of 100%? For example, this is a wire, length is L. 100% increase means again one more L is increased. This is L, one more L. So what is the total length here? 2L. It means that your length became 2L. Increase by 100% means what's the meaning? Length became 2L. So according to this equation, I can write resistance proportional to L square. If we are stretching, resistance proportional to what is the new length here? What is the new length? New length is nothing but 2L. So we can write it as 2L square. What is 2L square? 2L square is nothing but 4L square. 4L square means what is the meaning? The resistance increases by 4 times. Okay. So what I'm telling this one, it's a very important and very important twist. Normally we are learning like it, resistance is directly proportional to length. But what I have written here, resistance is proportional to L square because they gave here the length is increased by 100%. As the length is increased by 100% means the meaning is first length was L, now 100% total, one more increase. So L and L, so it will be total length is 2L. So the resistance should be increased to 4L square. 4L square means L square is proportional to R. So 4L square is proportional to 4R. So it means that what should be the, they ask what is the change in the resistance. Change in the resistance and they are given in percentage form. So we should find increase. First initial was the first one R1 equal to R. R1 equal to R. And R2 we are getting as 4R, right? So what is the increase in R? Increase in R is coming 4R minus R by R. 4R minus R by R into 100. 4R minus R is 3R. 3R by R, RR cancel. So it is 3 into 100. That is 300% increase. How much increase? 300% is getting increased. Clear? So it's very important, resistance is proportional to L square. So I can take here resistance is proportional to L square means I can write R become 4R. So what is the increase in R? 4R minus R by R into 100. That is 3 into 100. That is nothing but 300%. Hope you enjoyed the video. Please like, share and subscribe our channel. And press the bell button so that you will get the notification of our new video. Watch my next video, Electricity Part 3. Thank you.